Hey, I'm Kevin Bacon, and this is The First Time. First time I worked with David Koepp was on Stir of Echoes, and Stir of Echoes was a movie that David had written and directed, and I really loved the script. I found it super creepy.
All right, Kreskin, prove it. Might you hypnotize somebody?
Yeah, do me. Come on. What's the worst that can happen?
And we didn't know each other, but went off to Chicago and made this movie that I'm still very, very proud of. And, you know, ever since we made it, I wanted to do something else with him, but it took 20 years of, like, you know, kind of begging him, wearing him down to finally get to make You Should Have Left. My first movie was Animal House, and that was a pretty wild way to kick it off. I mean,
all is well!
I was a student at Circle in the Square Theater School. I was in this, they had a 2-year program. They called it a professional workshop. And a casting director from Animal House, I guess it was Universal, came to the school and said, we're looking for like college freshman preppy types. So the school said, well, we got this one guy, and basically they sent me over and I met John Landis, and there was a word that in the script that's, I think, said, I didn't have a lot of lines, but there was a word that they described the character as smarmy. And so he said, let me see you be smarmy, get smarmy. And I really didn't know what the word meant, but it was like an onomatopoeia where I kind of like said, well, I think smarmy is kind of be, so I started making these faces, and he's like, that's great. I love that. Then I kind of didn't really think about it. And for a long time, and I got a call in my apartment, and they said, it was the casting director, and he said, you got the part. And you need to be out here in Oregon. I'd barely been on a plane, honestly. You have to be out here in Oregon in 2 weeks. And I was like, well, 2 weeks? It was like not even 2 weeks. I think it was like the next week. I was like, my laundry, I got to pick up my laundry. And he's like, you don't understand. Either you're coming or you're not going to do this movie. I didn't have an agent, so there was really no deal to be made. He said, this is what you're getting. I said, okay, great. He said, we'll send you an airline ticket. And that was my first movie. I was in the very first Friday the 13th. I had a real classic horror movie death because I had sex with a girl and then smoked a joint. And if you do that and you're a young person in a slasher movie, that's it. It's over. Your history. Well, of course, I'm what pops into my head is Footloose.
Let's dance!
I wasn't a trained dancer. In my acting class, they sort of had a couple of movement classes, but it wasn't really, I didn't grow up as a dancer. But I loved to dance. I loved to go to clubs, and I was like, I would go out to Studio 54 and just go by myself and dance by myself. So when I was talking to the director about Footloose, they were like, and so we're going to have a choreographer. And I was kind of like, I don't need a choreographer. I mean, just turn on the music. I'll dance. I didn't really understand like the extent of, what it was going to be. I didn't get it. I feel like there was the audition, the screen test, but I think there was also a dancing audition as well, I remember. And when I got to California, we started at Paramount to rehearse before we moved to Utah. And I walked onto this soundstage, and they had taken an entire soundstage and turned it into a dance rehearsal room. And there was a wall of mirrors and a one of those ballet bars and rings and, things to jump on. And I was like, oh my God, what have I gotten myself into? And it was a really, really fast kind of an exhausting and challenging lesson. And come on, time to go. This is a dance movie. I think the first song I wrote, I was about 12 or 13 years old. The song was called All the World Looks Lonely Through Lonely Eyes. My idea for the song was that Michael Jackson would record it. Michael Jackson and I are same age, and you know, I love the Jackson 5. And so I kind of had this idea. It wasn't even for me to sing. It was for Michael Jackson to sing. I started writing songs before I could play an instrument, but I was writing melody. I would have the words and the melody in my head, and I would just kind of walk around and sing them. And eventually I would start singing them to my brother, and he would pick up a guitar and figure out what the changes were, and then kind of shape it into a, you know, I could hear it as a song. Yeah, I was a pretty young kid. First time we performed with the Bacon Brothers was in the 90s, probably 94 or 95. We had gotten a job down in Philadelphia. A friend of mine had asked me to come down and came up with his name, the Bacon Brothers. And he said, you know, you guys can do a show and I'll promote it. And in order to get ready for that show, we put a band together, which was basically a percussionist who played, you know, different hand drums, and a bass player. And then both my brother and I on acoustic guitars. I said to my brother, I'm not going to play the guitar in front of people. He's like, yes, you are, because we're not just having one guitar. We need to have two guitars. Well, obviously Tremors was my first scene that I worked with a Graboid. And interestingly, you know, I've been around long enough. I've seen the how effects have changed and grown and become amazing in terms of what can be done. Back when we were making Tremors, a lot of our effects were practical.
Must be a million of them. Nope, just one.
It's amazing to me that the movie and those monsters work as well as they do, because these days, you know, you would just create it, and you know, somebody would sit down with a computer and then, you know, draw it, and it would look perfect, and yet there's a certain kind of innocence and simplicity about looking at that film and the way that those effects are created, but they worked really well. It was interesting. People just sort of started saying it to me, you know, I've just played your game, or I'm so hungover, I was playing your game, or my friend's cousin invented a game about you. Like, a lot of people would claim that their cousin had come up with it. And then I heard about the guys that invented it from Albright College actually being on the Jon Stewart show. And it was a night Jon Stewart nighttime show. And I was also booked on the show. When I heard that they were going to be on, I was like, okay, this is really just, you're just making fun of me. You know, you're just like trying to cold cock me with this silliness, because I really didn't think, you know, to me, the game was sort of embarrassing. You know, it was not, you know, I thought it was kind of a joke at my expense. Then I went on, I met these guys, and you know, they were in the green room. They were really nice. They were, you know, young guys that actually seemed to like the movies. And then I just thought it would go away. And it just didn't go away. That was the surprise.